So, I didn't catch up with you after after Houston. So how would you say the weekend went there?
You know, that is funny because you didn't even ask me how my weekend was.
Man, I couldn't get to you.
Well, that's what happens when you get 15th place, you know? I mean, you don't get to how your weekend was. Obviously, it wasn't that good. Actually, the weekend was good. I mean, to be honest with you, I rode good in practice. Had a good heat race. It's unfortunate I had two crashes, and but I was healthy, didn't have a scratch on me. So, you know, unfortunately, it's not what I wanted to finish, but the weekend actually overall is good. I can race next weekend at San Diego, so I have no issues.
So how did the first turn crash happen? You know, I saw several of the guys were doing it.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of hard. It's you know, when they build the tracks like that, you know, it's kind of 50-50 chance. I'd probably been better off taking out the gate and stopping and letting everybody go. But you know, I kind of went sideways, hit in dungeon, and went back, and then kind of caught that tough block, and then got caught up in Chad. So that was nobody's fault. You know, everybody was going down all the time. You know, in the heat racing and stuff, and it was just my turn to go down.
Yeah, track was kind of sketchy, I guess.
Yeah, no, the track was. I mean, it is what it is. You know. You know, it sucks to come from like a track like Anaheim and, you know, even Oakland to go to a track like that. But, you know, we all raced it, and, you know, I was still able to be fast. Just unfortunately, I was on the ground twice, and, you know, that's what cost me. Mm-hmm.
So what do you, what's your recollection of the second crash with Jason?
With Jason, you know, it was just a racing incident. You know, I thought of, you know, I came around, I had plenty of room if he would have just doubled and hit the tabletop, but unfortunately he made a mistake on his own, and I'm sure he, you know, it bothered him also, and I just was committed. The way that jump was right out of the corner. You had to commit pretty much after the finish line to hit it, and I just committed and you know, just misjudged it. I thought he'd be gone when I got there, and we ended up tagging, and you know, that was the end of the story. It wasn't nobody's fault, you know, it was just a racing incident, and you know, just unfortunately we both got into the stick, and you know, definitely feel bad for him. And you know, feel bad for my team and the fans. You know, we always try to work hard, but you know, if I had to do it again next week, I probably would. It's just that's just the way the dice rolled.
Yeah. So we did a little catching up with Jason, and he said the same thing. It's more a racing incident than anything. But there's all these experts on the internet that are voicing their opinion. I mean, does that ever get you kind of down?
It does get me down because I don't even read it. You know, I think Jason knows as riders, you know, it's pretty plain and simple. You know, I wouldn't hurt myself, you know, especially in a situation like that. Villopoto was only two spots ahead of me. I was pretty calm, and like I said, you know, he just checked up a little bit more, and I did, and I jumped the jump. You know, it's nobody's fault, and everybody's an expert on this, and it just depends what side of the fence you're on, whose fault it is. But you know, I'll take the blame of it. You know, I landed on him and he went down, but you know, it's just like I said, a racing incident, and you know, if I wasn't the one who did it, probably somebody else would have did it. So you just move on next week and try to get the job done.
Cool. So your front rotor got bent up?
Yeah, you know, I bent my front rotor, so after I got up there, I was going to try to put another charge on, but every time I would jump, my front wheel would basically stop in the air. So I rode with that for, I don't know, 14 laps, so that was kind of a little bit frustrating. But like I said, at the end of the day, you know, I'm healthy, you know, so being on the couch last year, having a kind of similar incident and the tie going the other way, being second in the point standings and going, I still feel confidence. I feel like I'm still going to win this weekend, and, you know, we just move on.
So I know that locking up your rear wheel in there makes front end drop. What does it do when your front end locks up?
Yeah, it makes the front end drop even more. When you're front, you just feel like a spode. I was almost endoing over this little three after the whoops. I kept almost endoing over that, and finally the mechanics was like, dude, shut it down. But yeah, I'm a racer. I'm not going to pull off the track. You know, if I got 20th, I would have rode around and got 20th. Just, you know, I tell you, it's a long race back in 15th, and you know, you don't really got nothing going on. So pretty much, I just watched the race in front of me. I was watching the board go up and down, and you know, unfortunately my name wasn't on it.
It's kind of lame when the AMA guy cuts the transponder off and you got to ride up the tunnel instead of going to the podium alone.
I don't even think I got my transponder cut off. I just rode up to the tunnel. Malcolm told me I almost cleaned him out. You know, I said that would have been awesome. In the tunnel, laid down again for hitting my brother from walking. I guess we both had a rough night, but like I said, you know, I came back to the pits. I wasn't even upset. You know, it was just, you know, like I said, the way the dice rolled. And unfortunately, like I said, I'm healthy, and, you know, I still feel good for this weekend and the championship to come. I've been way worse situations, so, you know, I didn't even lose my sleep over this.
Cool. So, are you pumped to ride in the rain?
You know, Saturday's a long time away. I got like 72 hours left, so rain or shine, you know, I've won in the rain, I've lost in the rain, you know, so I won in sunshine, I lost in sunshine, so it doesn't matter, it's racing, and, you know, unfortunately, I just feel bad for the fans, you know, it's just one of those things. I'm sure nobody wants the rain, but, you know, the best guys are still going to be out front, and, you know, just looking forward to trying to get out there.
Cool. Thanks, Tom.
No worries.